हेलो
हेलो सर, रेडी? स्टार्ट
एक स्टार्ट मारवा।
मारते रहे, स्टार्ट मार फास्ट।
ओके सर, मुझे स्टार्ट।
सर, दिस इज द फेज थ्री प्रेजेंटेशन एंड इन द लास्ट फेज वी हैड शोन यू द थ्री ऑब्जेक्टिव्स आउट ऑफ द सिक्स दैट वी हैड कंप्लीटेड एंड दे वर बेसिकली बेस्ड ऑन द सॉफ्टवेयर साइड एंड इन दिस फेज show how we have implemented the next three objectives of our entire set of five objectives. Emily, can you change the slide? Sir, these were the five objectives that we had taken up for our project. And then we had done the first three objectives. And the next two objectives were development of MQTT server for wireless communication between the sensor and the processor. And the last one was the analysis of the following variables, role, pitch, and yaw. Sir, for establishing a wireless communication between the Raspberry Pi, which is the broker, and our client side is the ESP module, which is sending the sensor data to towards the Raspberry Pi. So we use a Mosquito broker, which is a ready-made broker available as a free source. And then we install the Raspbian OS on the Raspberry Pi, and then we install the Mosquito broker on the Raspberry Pi operating system. And with this, the Raspberry Pi becomes the broker for our project. So you can see that we have two commands in the terminal that we type. We type sudo apt update to update the available Mosquito broker if any is present in the Raspberry Pi. And the next is we write this command called sudo apt install dash y mosquito clients to install all the clients which are available. So when the clients will be installed, it means that the Mosquito broker, which is the Raspberry Pi, will sense all the clients available in the vicinity of the Raspberry Pi. Next slide. Sir, when we install all the Mosquito brokers, we test the installation. So, sir, you can see that in the terminal, we have mosquito.v. Then it tells the version, and then it uses the default configuration. And we also set a password and an ID for that. Because as we are told in the phase one presentation that we are trying to build a very secure project because it is based on the biomechanics side and we don't want any leak of a vital sensor data from a sports person. So we are adding a password and an ID for each and every messaging that will take place. Next slide. Sir, the Raspberry, the whole environment of Raspberry Pi being the broker and all the other ESP modules being the clients is based on a local Wi-Fi network. So the local Wi-Fi network will have an IP address. In this case, we had 192.168 as it is being highlighted in this. So all the connections will take place in this IP address and all the messaging will take place after it has been secured, and there will be an SSH key which will match with the key that we are trying to give so that there is a secured connection between all the sensor data which is being transferred.
So here we are testing the MQTT broker installation. So what is happening is we have to install the client for the given Raspberry Pi to which the ESP module will send the sensor data. So we are gonna enter the confirmation of the installation and run the Mosquito on the background.
So over here it is a distributed diagram of MQTT, how the MQTT works over here. So the publisher will basically publish a message into the server, and the subscriber, it can access the data from that server itself. So there is a basically a virtual channel created from the publisher to MQTT. So it's basically just the subscriber is trying to download some data from a server. It's that concept we are using over here. So in the next slide, we are showing how we are subscribing to the test topic by typing a command mosquito subd test topic. We are getting the subscriber in the next slide, we are showing how the message is being, next slide.
So here first, the message we are is sending the topic hello world clients. Into two different terminals. One is window one and another will be into window three. So in window two, we can see that we are sending the test topic hello world, which is being then sent to the window one where we are acquiring the subscriber topic name test topic. Here we can see in the last end of the window one that we are getting hello world after subscribing to the given window terminal. Then after that, also in window three, we can see the same hello world being displayed over here. So this is how we have actually built the Mosquito client on Raspberry Pi. Later on, we will see how we are acquiring the like getting the sensor data, how we will do data, further data processing on it. So our next final objective is analysis of the following variables, which will be explained by Kshitij.
So this basically includes the like we are importing the packages which were necessary for it in the NumPy and the pandas. In the next slide, we are using our describe function, which is used to view some basic statistical detail like percentile, mean, and standard, etc. Then raw data from the accelerometer is read in Python. We are using read function for it. And in the next step, analysis is being done to store the real-time reading and all. Next slide.
We are first acquiring the Excel slide. Sheet data of the given database, which we have got from the sensor.
So,
hello.
So these are the data which were acquired. Kshitij, I think Kshitij came in. Yeah.
Am I audible?
Yeah.
Audible?
Yeah.
Okay,
so here what we are doing is we are reading the sensor data that the sensor has sent to the server. So we are using it, we are using the pandas method to read the data, and then we can see that it has XYZ coordinates of accelerometer, gyroscope, and the magnetometer values. And here we have a redundant data that is temperature. So in the next thing, we'll remove this. So yeah, so we have removed the temperature because we don't need it for the analysis part. So we only need the accelerometer, gyrometer, and magnetometer values. Next. So now what we have done is we have extracted the accelerometer values. So we'll be doing the analysis on the acceleration part of this. So here we have the XYZ coordinates of the same.
Next slide.
So now we are doing the statistical analysis of the accelerometer values. So we have taken these many values. The count is this much and the mean of each coordinate axis, that is X, Y, Z, have been calculated separately. And the standard deviation minimum value, what is the minimum acceleration? 25% of the maximum value, 50% of the maximum value, 75% of the maximum value, and this is the maximum value. We have done it for the three axes.
Kshitij, I would like to, can you go back to the previous slide? I would like to add a very important astute observation here that sir, we have made the analysis on over a lakh quantity of data from the data set. So sir, we are using this large many number of data points so as to make the model more precise and accurate.
So to find the accuracy of the data, the following functions have been used.
So we are using the naive Bayes method to find the accuracy of our data set. It's one of the methods to analyze the accuracy. We have various other methods like random forest and all those, but this is the easiest way that we can do it. So our accuracy came out to be 93.8%, which is quite good. Next. So here we have calculated the pitch, roll, and yaw. That is a very important parameter, one of our objectives for the accelerometer value. So pitch and roll and yaw, the formula is the accelerometer x-axis divided by the square root of x plus y-axis. So using that formula, we have calculated the pitch, roll, and yaw.
Next slide. So now we had to find the time and pitch relationship and time and role and time and yaw also. So we have calculated, we have just formed the graph of time versus pitch relationship using the values which we found using the sensors. Even in the next slide and the slide after that, we have just found the graph of it. Next two slides.
So one of the main parameters that we wanted was if we are running on a long track and we wanted to know the where the person when he's running on the track, he's having a loss of energy. Being that if a person runs at least a person can't run on a uniform velocity, that means he cannot have zero acceleration. That is not realistically possible. But we want him to conserve his energy and run a longer marathon in the given way. So we wanted to find what is his acceleration in that given area where he's running. So the lesser the acceleration he has, the uniform velocity that we can expect from that person. So based on that, we tried to find the mean median of both the acceleration of X, Y, and Z axis, and also the median of the given data, which was shown over here. Would you like to add?
Adding to Ganesh's point, I would like to mention that whenever there is an acceleration on any of the XYZ components of an athlete's body, there is a loss of energy. So what we are trying to do is that we are trying to find the mean acceleration on any given point of axis. For example, let us take the Z axis. And then we are trying to see what is the minimum point when the marathon is being when the marathon is taking place. So whenever the acceleration value on any given axis is close to zero or it is tending to zero, it means that the loss of energy in that axis will be the maximum, and hence the athlete has conserved the energy which he would have applied if this analysis was not made. The next observation is that, sir, we can create a threshold in the previous three graphs that we are trying to analyze. Can you go to the three graphs of role versus time, pitch versus time, and yaw versus this time? One. Yes. Sir, in this graph, what we can do is we have taken a threshold value in this graph. For example, we have taken the threshold value from 8 to minus 4. So this will be the region of motion where we can say that the athlete is in an optimal range of motion. So whenever the athlete will cross the value of 8 on the positive side and minus 4 on the negative side, it will be certain that there is a loss of energy or some the posture is not correct. Because whenever the posture will be bad, the values of these accelerations of roll, yaw, and pitch will deter. So these two observations were purely based on the fact that these graphs are present. Yeah, Mool, you can go ahead.
We would like to show also our paper that we have done until now. Are you able to see the paper?
No.
No, paper is not
visible. Yeah,
it's visible.
So we have.
Can you zoom in the?
Yes. Thank you.
These are the various results that we have got and we have placed over here. Also, we are finding publishers for our paper in the current scenario.
Okay.
Ganesh?
Yes, sir.
Have you communicated this paper with any journal?
No, sir. We are still finding journals, sir. We have sent to one, but we haven't gotten a reply yet.
Like we got a plagiarism thing, like there was like
you could send to our RV journal itself?
No, sir. We haven't sent to RV journal. We'll send it, sir.
Sir, I heard that RV journal's timing ended, like it was Saturday, they said. Like one of my friends told me.
You could have sent it, no?
So like we got to know about it from IM people. We weren't knowing it. We got to know about it very later on. That's why.
At least you speak to guide and find the good journals. He know which are the good journals. So yes, this is a result oriented paper. So that send it to good journal only.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Swami?
Ah, sir.
Anything to add it to this and any doubt in this one, please ask.
No, sir, sir, is this time over? That RV journal time? Can't we submit RV now?
RV journal over. Last Saturday was the last date.
Okay. Okay.
You suggest them some other journal, which are some good journals, some Scopus Index journals are there. You can suggest.
Okay, okay, cool. Sir, is this only recommended only to submit the journal or conference not possible?
Good conference is also possible.
Okay, 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 okay. So probably we will find some of the good journals and the conferences and we will plan to submit such a weather, sir.
Yes. Ask them to. The result is good.
Yeah.
Ask them to the good Scopus Index journals only.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Or new journals like other nowadays people are talking. You can ask them to submit to good journal.
Definitely.
So by the time they will submit their thesis, they will get some communication.
Definitely, definitely, sir. Definitely. Yes. I will speak with.
Mudit.
Yes, sir.
So this that means you have completed the project in all respect.
Yes, sir. But we are having some sir, harder difficulties.
Yeah, that's what hardware issues are there, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
When can you suppose if college reopens?
Sir, it will take at least 2 to 3 weeks for the hardware to be perfectly fine, sir. That is the problem.
Hello.
Hello.
Sir, really? Hello. Sir, PK sir, I think your end, we couldn't able to hear voice. Hello?
Hardware interface madakke excuse beku ande avarge.
Mudit, how many days you need to implement same thing in hardware? Hello?
Hello.
Murli?
Sir.
Hello?
We need around 2 weeks, sir, for hardware. Like...
Hello, Murli.
Hello. Sir, are you able to listen?
No,
are you able to hear
sir
me?
Is asking, in order to implement this, how many days you required?
Sir, around 2 weeks, sir. Like, we have one working sensor over here, but we weren't
hello?
Able to get the batteries. Hello?
Hello, Murli?
Sir.
How many days you need to complete this? Same thing in an hardware implementation.
Sir, full software is working. Hardware will take 2 weeks, sir, around.
2 weeks. Okay, okay, okay.
Because we weren't allowed to bring batteries in flight, right? So we couldn't even bring soldering rods and everything also.
Okay, no problem. So what you can do, say now, the find very good journals that to be indexed in Scopus.
Yes, sir.
See, find out Cooper's Index journal. So you need to communicate within 2 days. By Monday, I wanted to know which journal you submitted. Yes, and sir. You would have sent me, right? For plagiarism, I can do that. I can send across to the department. In department, anyone of will do that plagiarism check.
Oh, okay, sir. We were actually doing ourselves only. We got the software. We got to know the software only. We also sent to the department also.
Yeah. So you send me across. I will test and give.
Yes, sir.
And but you need to send to anyone good journal, Scopus Index journal. You need to send.
Yes, sir. We will, sir.
Do that, ma. Yes, sir. At the earliest, okay.
Yes, sir.
By Monday, I wanted to know. Otherwise, I will tell you that which conference or the journal you need to submit. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Fine. Find a very good journal and let me know which one you are sending. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Same thing I will convey to sir also. Fine. Okay.
Yes, no problem. Thank you, sir.
The report is going on, right? Report writing.
Yeah, report is going on. By Monday, I will give you the report, sir.
Fine, ma. Fine, ma. Fine. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Mudit. Okay, Dul. Okay, I'm leaving.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Yeah.